minutes in the last couple of games. Needed to rest him up for this weekend. Anthony Sears back into it, trying to get him back in a game shape as he's been out for a few weeks. Katie Axemen right now looking probably to get a lot of her reserves in tonight. Going to go in with their usual starting lineup, but tonight they're going to have to go in and get the... Tonight they're going to have to go in and try and lock down a victory, go into the playoffs on the right note. They clinch the number 2 seed, Memorial, not making the playoffs, finishing last place in the conference, looking to build towards next season. Having a great fourth quarter last night, outscoring the Axemen by 14 in the final period.
And now the starting lineup for the Memorial Seahawks. Number 10, Mark Woodland. Number 14, Robbie Habib.
Robbie Habib last night having a great game to close it out, dropping 15 points in the fourth quarter alone.
Head coach of the Seahawks is Peter Kimball.
Jason Shepard in his fifth year as a local product from Black Oak, Nova Scotia.
Number 6, Jordan Cole. Number 8, Brad Steen. Number 10, Anthony Sears. Number 13, Sean Stoka. And number 14, Anthony Ash.
They're going out their usual starting lineup tonight. They're going to get off to a good note, probably going to get their reserves in as the game goes on. Acadia looking to push it, get to a wide open lead. Memorial trying to keep it close, maybe close out the season on a positive note. And here's the national anthem.
I'm joined again by my colleague Chris Carl. And Chris, what are the keys to tonight's game?
Tonight's game, for the Axemen anyways, they have to get off to a quick start here. No Owen, no inside presence, so you're going to have to move the ball around, get contributions from all five starters here. And if you're Memorial, you just got to do what you did in the fourth quarter. Hit your big man down low, spread the ball around, and really scrap here with the Axemen basketball squad here. You don't have the best record, but you never know. If you play hard and play some tough D, you might be able to pull out a win here at War Memorial.
Anthony Sears with the ball returning to action. He's been out for the last couple of weeks, coming back last night, trying to get him back in the game shape, ready for the playoffs.
Yeah, it looked like he had some good speed, good pop in his step with some time off, but a little fatigue there. Asked for some subs yesterday, just trying to get back into game conditioning.
Shepard with the ball now over to Habib. Habib setting up, having a great fourth quarter last night. Woodland over to Shepard, the local product right now, having a big crowd out supporting him tonight. Woodland, nice move. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Good defense by Stoka. Pulls up, rebounded by Gould. Down low, Caleb Gould had a pretty good night last night, and Brad Stage had his hand full with him.
Yeah, good job by Gould there, attacking the offensive glass, and good move there by number 10. Just taking the ball and leading to that offensive rebound. Then Acadia comes right back down, and Tall with a nice drive there, picking up the foul.
Axemen ball.
Inbounds it now. Ash trying to find it inside, can't get an open look. Paul for three. Doesn't go in. Acadia right now settling for 3-pointers on the first two possessions.
Yeah, it's a long-range shot with a hand in your face. Tough shot there for Tull. Like to see some easier looks to start the game, get themselves hot first before extending out to the three-point line.
Housby steps out around there. Acadia ball. 2-0 for the Seahawks. 8 minutes, 49 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Going into a bit of a press. Nice bounce pass in there. States now driving in. Look for him to take it in the air. Good job by Brad States, who had a nice article written about him this week in the Chronicle Hill.
Yeah, tough shot there by Brad States, but able to get in the body of the shot blocker and make a nice little hook over top of him.
Abib getting it into his big man. Trying to get back to him. Kicks out. Long range for Shepard. Shot falls. Nice shot by Shepard.
Shot by Shepard for sure. Hand in his face there. Good G by Axemen. Just better offense there by the Seahawks.
Sears going in. Gets his own rebound. Nice play by Anthony Sears battling down low.
Yeah, good play by Tall, too, to bring it out and reset here. Another look at the possession.
Nice drive in there by Ash going in. Nice layup.
Beautiful play there. Kind of faked out his defender. Looked like he was going to pull up for a long range three. He's a big threat from 3-point range, but simply just drove by him for the easy do.
Showing other areas to his game. Ash last night doing a great job driving in and getting in the paint and getting some easy shots. Caleb backing down Ash now. Size matchup. Nice rebound there by States.
Ash definitely giving up a lot of size down low, but definitely works hard for it.
Nice job by Ash getting in there. Finger roll. Shot doesn't fall. Last touch by State's going to be Habib's ball.
Yeah, tough shot there by Ash. A little out of control. He can make those, but you'd like to see some better possessions here from the Ash, and definitely with a lot of time still on the shot clock there.
Housby with the ball now. Trying to find someone open. A little congested right now. Backing down Sears. Nice fake. Kicks out Habib, open three. Shot's not good. Rebounded down low by Gould.
No offensive rebound. This is something that Katie is going to have to watch for.
He's going to go to line for three.
Yeah, Tell fouls the jump shooter from the 3-point. You never want to do that. But as we're speaking, that this whole possession here and these three free throws have come from another offensive rebound. That's too early on here. And without Owen Clausen in the game, it's going to take a whole effort from the entire Acadia squad here to rebound without their natural center in the game.
First shot's good. Up 6-4 right now. Seahawks trying to keep this one close, and now right now opening up to a 3-point lead now for the final shot for Shepard. In his last game as a Memorial Seahawk in his fifth year. Misses that one, rebounded there by Stokla. Stokla calling the play, setting up, trying to find some open work. Nice little play inside.
Good luck. A nice rejection there.
Caleb Gould.
Yeah, Gould there coming. Got sealed there. Looked like the Axemen had an easy layup, but recovered with a nice shot block there on Anthony Ash, and then knocks it off Ash for War Memorial or Seahawk ball here, sorry.
Fouls call on Gould there.
But unfortunately, Gould can't hold his position as the pass comes in. Stripped by Ash, and then he fouls Ash as he tries to go up for a fast break opportunity.
Stoker with it now. Acadia down 7-4.
Not such a quick start here. Last night they were firing on all cylinders with everybody making shots all over the place.
Nice shot by States there. Set him for the jump shot and showing his mid-range game.
Yeah, he's really got a complete game. He sometimes isn't too aggressive here on offense, but with Clausen out of the game, they're going to need him to keep scoring. And that was a beautiful little mid-range jump shot by States.
Tall now, Shepard. Woodland gets his pocket pick, fighting for it, regains the ball. Housby for three, shot clock winding down, and he nails it. 10-6 for the Seahawks.
Nice shot there by Housby. Not a great offensive possession for the Seahawks. Almost turned it over, but led to a wide open 3-point shot there by Housby.
Tall, in and out, not shots not falling for Acadia right now. Down 4. 5 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the first period. Habib finds Housby out, elects not to shoot, gets his pocket pick, battling for it, nice play by Ash.
Also by Ash there, covering that loose ball.
Call setting up to Stokoe, trying to get some movement right now for the Axemen. Sears goes for three. Shot short.
Tough shot there by Sears. You can definitely heat up from the outside, but the hand in his face, you might want to look for a better look if you're the Axemen.
Trying to get the ball inside now. Kicks out to Habib. Driving in. Knocks States back. Woodland, long two. That shot's no good. Battling down low, States ends up with the ball.
Good crash in the glass there by the Axemen. All four coming back.
Nice play by Tull getting the layup. Great move breaking down Helsby as he sinks the easy layup. Oh, to Helsby now. Acadia down 10-8. 4 minutes remaining in the quarter. Not the start the Axemen wanted now. Shepard gets it over to Habib for three. Shot's good. And it's long two. 12-8 now for the Seahawks. States with the ball now. Going to see some subs shortly. Stoker with it. Kicks out to Tall. Tall makes a nice catch. 9 seconds left on the shot clock. Settles for a three. In and out. Nice shot by Tull. Just didn't fall for him there. Acadia up 12.
A lot of one-on-one still for Acadia. Not much movement. No one really moving around. So you can't collect those offensive rebounds off the long misses. So they're just settling for a lot of threes here.
Helsby for three. That one's good. He's shooting the lights out. 50-8 for Memorial. Acadia's going to
start for Memorial here. Hitting a lot of shots right now.
Sears right now getting it. That shot doesn't fall. Acadia 7 for 3 is early in the possession. It's not going too well for them.
They've gone a bit cold, for sure.
Woodland takes it out. Habib for long 3. Doesn't go. Shot's long. Ash collects it. Your rebound. Moves it up calmly. Nice move by Acadia. Sears with it. Bounce pass in, States there, draws the contact, shot falls, States now with his third field goal.
I like that play from Acadia, simple little pick and slide, sealed his man, and good find there by Anthony Ashton, a better finish there by States, who comes up with the steal, steps
out of bounds. Oh, it could have been a highlight real play for States as he couldn't climb the ladder and make some big dunks.
Good hustle there by States as he gets some subs coming in.
So Filigiano, Scott coming in for the Axemen. Ailman and Wood coming in for Memorial.
Number
13, Ryan Wood, and number 22, Justin Allen. Katie, coaches wondering why there's a reset on the clock.
Yeah, Katie kind of arguing there was no actual possession there.
Oh, we get a big block there by Ash.
Ferocious play there by Anthony Ash, who just rejects the Seahawk attempt.
For a perimeter player, he really shows that he's a tenacious defender.
Yeah, he might not be the biggest guy on the floor, but he definitely doesn't give it up with heart and desire as he battles hard in the paint as the fourth, as the actual fourth man power forward in the, as a big for Acadia.
Big play there by Helsby, rejecting that shot. Allen. Over to Helsby, 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Acadia down 5 right now. Nice play by Habib. Backing him down, goes in, puts up the shot, draws a foul. Going to go to the line for 2.
Yeah, if you're Filigiano, you don't just want to stand your ground. No need to go bump into him like that. Shooting an off-balance shot, let him take that. He makes it, he makes it, but it's definitely a tough shot. But bailing him out, giving him 2 easy free throws is definitely not something you want to do there.
Lachlan Gale coming in now. Bringing in Gale, hopefully to shore up what's happening in the paint right now. Katie getting back down. Caleb Gould, who's on in right now, was having some success working on Brad States. States just in his first year right now. Former Mr. Nova Scotia for basketball, Mr. New Brunswick for basketball.
State's a big leaper, but not a natural big man. So he's going to have to get thicker over his years here at Acadia. But without Owen Kloss in the game, you can see how Seahawks are trying to take advantage of the lack of size here for Acadia on the floor.
Unfortunate turnover there for Lachlan Gale. Elsby with it, setting up, working on Sears, trying to find someone open. Elects to shoot the 3.
Tough shot there by Elsby.
Katie coming back on the fast break. Sears working one-on-one. Foul call there on Habib. He doesn't agree with that one at all, though.
Yeah, you simply just can't reach in like that as to be stand your ground, try to take the charge, and if he tries to take a tough shot over you, you'll have to live with that.
Foul called on Sears there. illegal screen called against Sears. Unfortunate foul there. Another turnover for Acadia in the offensive zone.
Yeah, a little sloppy start here for Acadia with only a minute 42 left. Only 10 points. They probably had that in the first minute last night. So not quite as hot from the outside. And it's led to some unforced turnovers and sloppy play here early on.
Okay, really going to have to find a groove with Owen Klassen out, which could happen in the game. We saw last weekend against the UPI, Klassen fouling out, Acadia having to battle back with that.
Nice trap defense there by Acadia, collapsing on the in the paint and coming up with that steal.
Sears, athletic play, catching the ball, trying to put up Allen, doesn't go. Lachlan Gale getting called on the foul. It's Acadia's fifth foul, I believe.
Yeah, a little force there by Sears. Tough shot attempt, definitely good defense there by the Seahawks, who number 40 there, holding his ground. And that's, Jason Shepard there playing some great D, just keeping his hands up and not allowing Sears to get an easy look at the basket and caused him to miss that. And another foul here by Lachlan Gale, and Moore will dribble off the ball.
Pardon me, that's a 14 foul for Acadia now, one away from the bonus. Caleb Gould now, Woodland. Nice play by Helsby, faking the pass. Woodland.
It's a tough shot there by Woodland. Gets it blocked, but unfortunate play for the Axemen. They turn it over, bouncing it off their own foot, giving the ball right back to the Seahawks.
Katie can't be turning the ball over like that in their own zone right now, struggling offensively. Giving Seahawks second chance, especially right now with the Seahawks offense playing uncharacteristically right now. This team hasn't been able to score too much this season. Katie letting them get 15 points in the first quarter. Open shot for Phil Jano. Shot doesn't fall. Rebounded there by Wood. Katie was settling for these three-pointers. That's an open look, but they got a fall.
Yeah, they can get hot from outside, but you can live and you can die from the three-point range, and that's what they're doing right now, just fading away, losing.
Tyler Scott there, a little miscommunication, thinking that Acadia would regain the foul going on the fast break. Fortunately for him, getting back on defense.
Travel.
Travel called. 3-point doesn't count for the Seahawks.
That would have been allowed there in the NBA where you'll have to catch and step into it like that, but not quite allowed here in the CIS. And unfortunate for Memorial, who hits a 3-point but doesn't get it to count with the travel call.
Phil Jano now letting the clock go down.
Yeah, playing for one last shot here.
Okay, trying to whittle down the lead, down 5 points. Cross court, nice play by Wood.
Almost stolen.
Gonna have to go to NBA range. A little far there, but Sears for three. That one doesn't fall. Acadia, poor shooting right now from the 3-point range. Living and dying with that. As you said before, if you're gonna win in the tournament, you're gonna have to win with your bigs. And Acadia right now, struggling without Owen Klassen, and struggling to find points inside. Last game, they were hitting everything from outside in 3-point range. Tonight, they've gone cold, and that's the result of the score. Acadia down 5 going into the second quarter. To get into the halftime show, we'll see what the coaches are going to do. Acadia, this game means nothing for either team. Memorial eliminated from playoff contention a long ways ago, struggling this year with only 2 wins. Acadia locked up the bye right now. But you don't want to go into the playoffs on a cold note like this, especially with the most of the starters in.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's a bad start here for Acadia. Not really what they wanted to do or come out doing, but we'll see if they can kind of get it back together here and hit some shots here. They definitely went cold. And if you're the Seahawks, it might not be a nothing game in the standings, but it's definitely not a nothing game for your season. I mean, you want to go out on a winning note, get things going in a positive direction for the years to come, as you might have some younger players here getting some minutes and guys who can show maybe they belong on this team and will lead to some future success for the Seahawks.
So Seattle is going to keep the Memorial playing extremely well right now. Katie Hood, don't want to say they underestimated their opponent, but both Memorial teams played very well today. Even the women's team in the early match fighting back down by 30, ended up losing by 3, having a shot in the final possession to tie it, unable to do so. Right now, watching the Acadia Axemen struggling from 3-point range. Most of their hot shooters have gone down right now.
Here come the stats here. We're definitely going to see a low field goal percentage for the Axemen in the first half there.
Acadia, wrong stats that we're giving right now. We're going to have to wait till halftime stats. That was for the girls game. see 66 shots, so there wasn't that many.
A little statistician problem here.
We'll get a new set right now, but
but unfortunately for the Axemen, we know they haven't hit a three yet, which is definitely their strong point. So we'll see if they can warm up a little and see if the Seahawks can continue their hot shooting.
How's Bede unable to get that one? Almost a travel there. Allen managing to an athletic play with their little trick footwork. Nice play inside there, falling for Helsby. Helsby having a great game so far.
A great game there, using his body, not allowing the shot blocker to get in the air at all, and comes up with the easy two.
States goes inside and misses the easy, and that's the kind of game for the Acadia Axemen so far.
I mean, States, a guy who throws in 360 windmills and warm up, big time leaper, just missing the easy dunk there. Basket here for the Seahawks as the Axemen fall asleep on defense.
Tyler Scott with it for three. That one falls. First 3-pointer for the Axemen. They needed that one. Down six now.
That's for sure. Big shot there by Scott, getting the Axemen on the board, and definitely from 3-point range. Maybe they can heat up off of that make.
Nice move inside. Travel called against Helsby.
Second travel there for Helsby. Unfortunate, because the Seahawks were really on a groove in offense, but big turnovers there, and the Axemen can come back up the floor and make this a closer game here.
Phil Jano with it now, over to States. Tall electing to go inside. Oh, that shot not falling for Tall. Cable can't buy a basket right now.
A beautiful drive there by Tall, just unfortunately rims out there.
Helsby with it now. Get a little more movement in Memorial's offense, more than we saw last night. Oh, nice play by Phil Jano.
Nice by Phil Jano in the lane.
Oh, last touch by Acadia.
Nice try there by States, trying to keep the ball in the bounds, but unfortunately steps out just as he swats it back in.
Helsby sits down now. His hometown product, Shepherd's coming in. Quite a big Memorial contingent now. Fans traveling more for the Seahawks. Nice play by Shepherd, kicking out. Wood for three, and that one falls. Big three-pointer. Acadia now trailing 22-13. Ryan Wood with a three. Acadia with most of their starters in right now. Scott having to start last weekend. Tull in. Phil Jano started last year, playing lots of minutes for the Axemen in relief of Stokoe right now. States climbing the ladder, one on four, getting the ball, jump ball possession. Acadia ball. As Anthony Ash is going to re-enter the game now.
Axemen substitution returning to the game, number 14, Anthony Ash.
Ash re-enters the game. Acadia down 22-13, 8 minutes remaining in the half.
Yeah, Acadia's going to have to find some success here on the offensive end. Try to get the ball in the paint. I know they don't have the big men, but no excuse not to kind of work an inside-outside game here.
A foul called on Caleb Gould inside.
Yeah, simply reaching over the back. Unnecessary foul there. Let him catch the ball at the top of the key and just play good D. Solid D behind him. No need to reach there.
Phil Jano trying to find someone open, finds Tall. Tall floats it in.
Works it inside here.
Nice move by Gale. Gale for two, falls in. Nice play by Lachlan Gales.
Not bad play there by Gale, just shooting a little jumper over the big man. Can't quite back him out that hard, but shoots a nice little floater.
Good defense by the Axemen, getting a little more aggressive. Good right now, kicks it out. Halliman works it down low. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Bounce pass in there. Oh, and the lock.
Big block there by Phil Jano, the guard.
Secondary help there. Lachlan Gale is going to come down too. Great play by the Axemen, collapsing on defense. And oh, big block there by Wood as he stands there. Aaron Myers' work. Great play by Wood.
Wood coming from the backside there. Good outside defense from both teams as they trade big blocks on both ends of the floor.
Inside. And there's a foul on Tyler Scott. Nice play by Woodland, recognizing that Scott was out of position, getting the leverage on him and going in.
Yeah, the Axemen caught a couple times here with some backdoor screens, kind of falling asleep, turning their back to their defenders, and anytime you turn your back, it can be very dangerous as they can slip behind you for those easy baskets.
Katie right now huddling up all the players on the court as Sears and Stoker re-enter the game.
And for Acadia, Sean Stoka, and number 10, Anthony Sears.
Katie with four starters in the game now. Stoka, Ash, Tull, Sears in. Lachlan Gale playing more minutes today as Clausen's out. Katie now down 24-15. Nice moving by Katie. starting to get more motion in the offense. Ash for three, shots not falling for the Axemen though, settling for threes early in the time clock. Habib bounce it down low. Shepard trying to dribble in, nice move, help comes in, shot falls, nice play by Shepard in front of his hometown crowd. Nice play, Tull driving in, goes for a layup. Gonna go to the line now to shoot two. Tull showing all of his athleticism and speed there, splitting the defense and getting to the line. Acadia's gonna have to start hitting these to get back in the game because they're cold from 3-point range.
Yeah, that's for sure, Kevin. You're completely right. I mean, when you're not hot from the outside, you got to get to the line. You got to get into the paint, get some easy baskets, get yourselves going. Some of these free throws might heat up some of these shooters for the Axemen, but you can't just keep shooting up threes when you're not knocking them down.
Acadia Widows lead down to nine. Shepard with it, trying to find someone. Finds Wood. Wood pulls up, shoots, doesn't go in.
Put a jumper for Wood. Not a bad shot, just falling away. You want to collect yourself, go straight up, and you might make that one instead of hitting the front rim.
Over to Tull. Tull likes to drive, goes in one on two. Blocking foul call, going back to the line for two. Tull doing everything to get points right now, really, instead of settling for a three-pointer, showing his speed.
Yeah, he's not settling. He's being real aggressive and going to the basket hard, and that's what these Axemen need right now, some easy points, something come easy, because can't seem to hit anything right now from outside. Really struggling early on. A different story from last night's game, and Seahawks really battling, and we're down about 30 at halftime last night. With the lead, actually, right now by 9 points, as Tull goes line for two.
First shot falls for Tull. Tull really gonna whittle down the lead, get into the line. Gonna get some substitutions in now for Memorial. Helsby's gonna re-enter the game now.
Memorial substitutions return to the game, number 33, Mike Helsby. Entering the game, number 11,
Timo
Sargent.
So Sargent and Helsby entering the game right now. Alleman with it. KD down 26-19. Nice play inside there. Alleman setting up. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Good hands by Tull. Shepard with it. Stuck. Likes for a long three and doesn't go. Good bounce, unfortunate bounce. Alleman climbing above the trees, getting that one.
Yeah, you got to box out if you're these Acadia guards. Such a big in there, you need some help, and you can't allow your guard to slip in there. And the offensive rebound and leads to another Acadia foul. And Memorial will go to the line for two here and try to extend their lead.
Acadia substitution returning to the game, number 8, Brad State.
State re-enters the game now. As Gale takes a seat, Acadia really going to have to start working working harder in the paint right now, because there seems to be lanes. That's what Memorial is exploiting right now. It's some dribble drive penetration inside the lanes, finding seams. Both shots are good for them. 28-19 now for the Seahawks. Tull with it now. Tull driving in again. Lex not to go. Nice hand pocket there. Shepard on a 2-on-1. Acadia getting back on defense. Shepard called on the charge.
I think it may be a turnover, not for a foul. Sure, we're getting some arguments here by the Seahawks coach, but either way, it's Acadia basketball as they dribble it up. Down by 11 right now. Or correction, sorry, 8.
Tull with it. Goes for the three. Doesn't go in. Tall's a little cold now from outside. Ball to all the Acadia. Alleman contested two.
There. Great D by Stokoe. Puts his hand right in the eyes of the shooter.
Not too sure why they're selling for those ones right now when they're having so much success driving in. Sears now with the ball. Sears returning to action. Fine state. Good movement. Stokoe for three. Gets roughed up as he falls down, but Acadia gets the ball. Sears for three. Nothing's falling for Acadia, missing fourth straight three-pointers. Struggling at that point of the game right now. Timo Sargent kicks it out. Nice play.
Good ball movement here by the Seahawks.
Habib for two. Nice shot over two.
Good ball movement leads to a nice little jumper by Reed, who knocks it down and extends this War Memorial, Memorial lead. Sorry.
That one's good for Ash. Ash from the sweet spot for him. He doesn't miss too many from that area. Acadia down eight now.
The second three-point make here by Acadia, who's struggling from downtown, but could be heating up here as a full quarter. Oh,
pocket almost picked there. Ironman with the ball.
One more stagnant offense here by Memorial.
Acadia right now playing pretty good defense, forcing the turnover.
Yeah, see, the previous possession, Moore had great success when they moved the ball. They attacked quickly. Lots of swinging. Not letting Acadia get set up. That time, a lot more stagnant movement and led to a turnover.
Nice play. Stoker gets fouled and the shot falls. Goes to the line now and one. Great play for the young Axemen.
Yeah, and he was on fire last night. Only his first mate tonight, but we'll see if he can eat up. He's really leads to a lot of success. Because teams having to start double teaming and find his teammates, really what he really does best.
Katie going on a bit of a run there. Coach Benoit likes to call a timeout.
I just want to mention that all those that played today in the, or this year or since January and donated $2 towards Shoot Cure, we raised $362 from that. And I'm going to get our announcer here to draw a name. Here we go, he's so happy. He'll even announce the name. That's your job.
Mike Taylor. You're in the building, Mike Taylor. You want a sweet fridge.
So that Budweiser fridge that everyone who comes to games has been wanting all year has finally been drawn off.
That coveted prize goes to Mike Taylor. Congratulations to him. It's a lovely looking Acadia Axemen fridge. It's a lot of awesome athlete pictures on it and the Acadia logo, so that's something that will definitely look good for Mike Taylor and his bar, wherever he decides to put it here. As
been pining for that all year.
I know, unfortunately we couldn't win it ourselves here, Kevin, but we got 3 minutes left here in the first half, folks. It's Acadia down by six with Sean Soko at the line shooting one.
Shots good. Acadia down five now, starting to whittle away. Acadia in a bit of a press defense.
Yeah, you can see they're picking up their intensity a bit more. A little lackluster start this game, but some trapping going on. A little full court pressure.
Abid, nice moving. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Acadia very aggressive right now. Inside finds the open look. Great defense by Brad State.
Seahawks look to have a wide open layup there, but swatted by Brad States and then taken all the way up the floor by Anthony Ash for an easy two.
Acadia now down three. 3 minutes remaining in the half.
The Seahawks, somebody's got to stop the ball carrier there.
Nice button movement. Habib for three. That shot's not good. Acadia gets a rebound now. Good ball movement for Moore. They're unable to get the shot to fall.
Yeah, if you're Habib, you might want to position yourself a little better. You're not bad from the three-point lane, but that's not your area of expertise, so maybe get yourself in the paint and get yourself an easier look there.
And Ash, it's a three. Acadia ties the game up 30-30. Memorial right now has to stop this run for the Axemen if they want to keep it.
Acadia really warming up here. Let's see if they can keep battling here and maybe get a lead going in the half. And if you're Memorial, you really don't want the Axemen heat up from long range, so that could be deadly for your success today.
Nice play by Helsby, unable to get it. Acadia ball. Caleb Gould's going to re-enter the game now. Go with a bit more size as Acadia doesn't seem to have too much of an answer in the low post right now with States and Walker and Gill both alternating time today. Stoker advances the ball now. Acadia tied the game up. 2 minutes remaining in the half. Tull with it. Sears returning to action. Likes to drive, gets rejected in there by Shepard. Nice play by Shepard, rejecting the return in Axemen. Housby calling the shots right now, telling players where to situate. Nice move inside the Woodland. If Woodland could catch that, that would have been an easy two, but Acadia gets called on the foul.
Yeah, Stoko trying to recover there after losing his man underneath.
Just simply cards in the push foul there by Sean Stokoe.
Stokoe's first foul, Acadia's third team foul. 30-30, minute 48 remaining. Helsby gets the ball. 13 seconds left on the shot clock.
Acadia going a little 2-3 zone here.
Out to Woodland. 5 seconds left on the shot clock.
Moreau trying to sneak in behind.
Oh, open look for Woodland. Shot foul. Big shot for Woodland there. Acadia picking up the pace though now. Stokoe bringing it up.
A bad zone there by Acadia. Just simply lost Woodland as the shot clock expired, and he was able to nail a big three there.
States for three. Shortest three-point game. Unable to sink that one.
Not quite able to get that one dropped. Not a bad shot by States there, who can extend to three-point range at some times as Tabeek. Just a bad turnover there as he travels. You gotta put the ball down before you walk.
33-30 right now for the Seahawks. Acadia trailing again. They managed to tie it up. A big shot by Woodland to take the lead. Almost a minute left in the half. Nice play by Stokoe driving in. Draws a foul, getting back to the line.
A good by the undersized Stokoe, definitely using his athleticism there, driving by and causing the foul there.
Memorial shooting foul committed by number 10, Mark Woodland. Sean Stokoe to shoot two for the X.
For sure, it's no good for Stokoe. Second shot's good. Acadia trails two now, under a minute left, 59 seconds. Acadia now on the bonus as well. Nice bounce pass inside though. Memorial ball now, 19 seconds left on the shot clock. Helsby trapped there, gets it out. Three for Shepherd. That one's good. 3-point range for Memorial. It's been open all day.
Yeah, and this zone that Katie's playing can lead right into Memorial's hand. Is definitely can lead to some open threes if you move the ball, which is exactly what they did there.
3-pointer for Ash. That one's good. Trading 3 points. Acadia down two with 30 seconds remaining in the half.
Beautiful little shake there, Ash. Almost gets his defender to fall over before making the long three.
A nice play by Tall poking the ball away. 21 seconds remaining in the half. Overland back call to Acadia ball. Unfortunate turnover there. Shot clock's going to be off now.
Stokoe applying a lot of pressure on the ball handler and causing him to get the over and back call. For Memorial, you got to keep playing with poise. I mean, you've built up a little 3-point lead here. You're playing with the highly ranked Axemen squad. No need to panic now.
Nice play by Tull going inside. Easy 2-point play there, Acadia.
That seems like it's been open all day for him. Simple drive, just flies by his defender and easy layup for two.
Acadia down by one, playing for the final shot. Woodland overruns the ball, but gets a foul call on Stokoe. 14 foul, Stokoe's second foul. Phil Jano's going to get in for Stokoe now.
Substitution for the X-Men, returning to the
5 seconds remaining. Helsby with it. Woodland. 3-pointer rejected there by States. Ash throws it down the court.
That's probably the third block of the game here for Brad States, who's been all over four for the Axemen. And we got a 1-point Memorial lead as we head in the half, which is a big change from last night's 30-point lead that the Axemen had. So Memorial coming out with a little more heart, a little more battle today, and Axemen came out a little bit slow. Kevin, I don't know what you see here, but I just see a little lackluster effort here. Katie's starting to pick it up, not wanting to get embarrassed here as in their last game at their home gymnasium.
Katie right now settling for 3-pointers, struggling right now, going into the half down 1-2 lackluster Memorial team, who's only has 2 wins on the year, trying to end the season on a high note. Key players right now has to be Helsby and Habib, and with that we'll go into halftime and let you enjoy the Acadia Minor basketball program. back to Acadia Axemen basketball on the SSN Network. Acadia Axemen currently trailing the Memorial Seahawks 36-35. With that, we got some stats. Chris Carl's going to go over it right now.
All right, well, we got Acadia getting out-rebounded hard, 23-18, but the big killer tape is the 8 offensive rebounds the Seahawks have gathered. That's 2 more than they gathered all last night. And a big, big stat here for the Acadia Axemen. Usually a great three-point shooting team, only shooting 3-for-15 for 20% from the three-point line. Everything else is fairly even for both sides as we start this second half. But Katie's going to need to hit a little more three-point shots and a little more shots overall to beat this scrappy Memorial squad.
Brad State's taking on Dennis when foul there, a little out of control, hard foul on Caleb Good.
Saw the Axemen kind of come out early here after a talk in the change room. I think coaches kind of got on them through their tempo, and you saw them come out really get into the warm-up, and let's see if it translates to a little more intensity here in the second half.
Stoker gathers a defensive rebound, brings it back. Nice play by Tull going inside. Hard play, doesn't get the fall, though.
Tough play, good D by Gold there, standing his ground, and Tull trying to make a circus shot, but unable to.
Shot doesn't fall there for Helsby, but he's going to go to the line for two. Great play by Helsby. He's having a fairly productive night right now with 8 points. Jason Shepard, the local product, leading all scorers with 12, tied with Anthony Ash, who also has 12. Ash, uncharacteristically, missing some three-pointers though right now. Trying to drive a bit more, though. 5-for-9 in field goal range.
Yeah, I think it was Helsby really started off the game well. Hit a couple early threes for the Seahawks and really got him off to a jump start that Katie was never really able to respond early on until late in that second half. That's why we got such a tight game here, folks, with a three-point lead for the Seahawks.
Nice play by Sears going in on the baseline, getting up and under, getting the layup.
Yeah, good offensive play there by Sears, taking it hard and being real physical, not allowing his defender to push him off there, and goes up strong for the easy two.
Shepard inside, finding Habib back door, getting pushed out of bounds. Nice recovery, though.
Still
2-on-2, heading back right now. Nice breakdown, goes in, draws a foul, shot in and out, doesn't fall. We're going to go to the line for a chance to take the lead for the Axemen.
A little hesitation crossover there by young Sean Stokewell, who takes it in and draws the foul. We'll shoot two free throws.
Shooting foul committed by number 10, Mark Woodley. Sean Stokewell to shoot two for the Axemen.
First shot falls, tie game, 38-38, 8 minutes, 53 seconds remaining in the third quarter. That one's good as well, 39-38, Axemen lead right now, first lead in a while for them. Referee said that was a kick. Helsby with it now. Katie trying to press a bit. Helsby in a bit of trouble, and there's another turnover. Seahawks don't want to get into this bad habit again, having 10 turnovers already, giving Katie
a little
chances.
Change of pace there by Katie, picking up full court, getting a little trap going, and
Sears decides not.
Sears unable to make the two.
Sears electing not to take the three there, going in and driving, trying to get to the line.
I don't mind that play for sure by Sears, trying to get himself going a bit, keep attacking the basket hard.
Nice play there, Stoker for three. Misses that one.
Another hit. Ooh.
Nice little play there by Habib, good awareness. Nice play by States, active hands, not deflecting that one out of bounds. We're going to get a substitution as Allerman's coming in for Woodland.
Yeah, definitely good play there by States, cutting off that pass as Habib was wide open there in the corner.
As we restart right now, Helsby with it, 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Acadia up by 1 point right now in the final game of the AUS regular season. Acadia already clinching the second bye into the playoffs.
That's a bad shot there by the Seahawks. Not much going on, and then just launching a three-point.
Sears with it now, going in, driving the lane, getting the contact. Nice foul. Nice call there by the referees, letting the players play. Acadia unable to get that offensive board there. Referees allowing the players to bear a bit and not calling it. Going inside there, nice play there. Caleb goes to the ground though, had an open look there. Two players back, would have banged up. Acadia heading back with numbers. Sears the open three, drains that one. Acadia.
Fine there by Tull, unselfish play. Running up the floor and finding his teammate wide open in the corner. That's
Anthony Sears for three.
Slowing it down now. Memorial needs to answer on this possession right now. Acadia starting to go on a bit of a run.
A lot of standing around going on for Memorial.
Shepherd sells for the three.
Another long three. Acadia out on the break.
Good fast pace there. Tall gets a pocket pick there. Turnover. Walking foul called there. Reach in.
Technical actually called on Jonathan Tull. I think after he turned over, might have said something to the ref asking for a foul. And, fortunately for him, a little technical, but you know, that those can happen from time to time. Just want to leave it to the coaches, though, to talk to the refs.
First shot falls. Something Katie didn't want to do now, especially with Memorial struggling so much to find offense. That one hangs on the rim and falls. Memorial retained possession now, down two. Katie was doing a great job on offense. You don't want to give them three shots at the line. Memorial's not too bad at the line right now, shooting 75% at the break. Percentage only going up now as they get the two. Katie up 42-40 now, 6 minutes, 59 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Shepard gets the ball. Gets it into Gould, another turnover. Stoker gets it. Katie up with numbers. Stoker decides to slow it down. Open states. Katie a little too unselfish there, but retains possession.
Yeah, good recovery there by the Seahawks. Looked like it was a quick 3-on-1 there. Quite a little misdribbles there by Stoker, and Seahawks able to come back and bat it out of bounds.
Open look for Sears. Likes to drive down the baseline, up and under. Doesn't get it to go. States battling 1-on-4. Habib gets the ball. No foul called, but Katie a ball. No more ball.
That's a tough take there by Sears. He makes a lot of those acrobatic shots. He's just unable not to get the ball to spin in there. And Katie just take white, collect the offensive rebound. Good defensive possession for the Seahawks, who are coming down on the offensive end here.
Allerman with it. Going in, shot falls, tie game.
Yeah, Katie kind of fell asleep there on D and lost Adelman, who came in for the easy little floater.
Ash with it, decides not to shoot the three, dribbles in, takes the foul, hard foul there by Gould.
A nice play there by Ash. Some little pump fake got by his defender and a little kind of hesitation move and able to draw the foul for two.
That's Gould's third foul, I believe.
Anthony Ash to shoot.
Yeah, and they'll sub him out. They don't want to roll the dice with him. He's having a great game so far. They can't have him foul out. As Lockwood and Gale is going to enter the game now.
And return to the game for the Axemen, number 12, Lockwood Gale.
First shot's good. Acadia takes a 1-point lead now. 6 minutes remaining in the period. That shot's good as well. Katie up two. Going back in the press. Finding open Allerman.
Memorial looking to come out on the break.
Oh, has to catch that one. Shepard's not happy about that one as he slams his hand down on the bench. Don't want to do that.
Yeah, Katie doesn't cause the turnover, but they do cause the turnover. Not with the steal, but just picking up the pace and forcing Memorial to go a little faster than they want to, and he passes it out of bounds.
Gets it into Lachlan Gale's position. Nice play by Sears, head fake. Oh. Hangs in the air, unable to sink the shot, but it'll be a Katie ball as it bounced off Hasby. 9 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Katie up by two.
Good move there by Sears. Maybe be a little unselfish. Find your big man here. Might have been slipping in the basket, but either way, Katie retains the ball and will attack here on offense.
And Ash unable to hit that shot. Foul called, though. Called against Lachlan Gale.
Called on the rebounding foul.
It's Katie's.
It was an over and back.
Katie's fourth team foul now. Much closer game than we anticipated right now. Katie only up two in the third quarter. Shepherd, head fake.
So what happens if you let a team hang around and give them some confidence early. They can do this to you, and they grab the 1-point lead here. Halfway through the second quarter, or third quarter.
Ash now, driving in. Gets it to fall, and one, going back to the line. Nice play by Ash, to regain Acadia's lead and hoping to extend it.
Kind of going 1-on-5 there, Anthony Ash.
just kind of taking it in by himself, but spins in the lane, draws the foul, and makes the basket. He's looking for the three-point play here at the free throw line.
Gets that one to go. Acadia now up to 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Housley with it. Acadia back into the press. Ball tipped. Alderman wisely lets it go out.
Seahawks having a little trouble here with the press. See if they can calm down and regain their poise here.
Shepard gets it into Habib. Habib looking for someone to get open. No, not. Nice play. Unable to handle the pass though. We're back to Housley. Backing down Ash. Oh, not Ash. Lachlan Gale. Draws the foul and gets it going. Nice play by Wood. The up and under. Hoop in the harm. Going to the line for one.
Yeah, Katie falling asleep two times on that possession there. But quick backdoor cuts and losing their offensive players. And it's leading to some easy opportunities here. The Seahawks to make the beautiful play there by number 13, Ryan Wood, who gets the and one and will now shoot the free throw.
That one's good. Trading leads now. Memorial up by one. Acadia picking up the pace a bit. Tall with it. Going in hard. Drives in. Doesn't get it to fall. Ash with it. Battling down. People going. And there's Lachlan Gale. Going to go to the line now. Looks to be. Starting to get a bit of foul trouble now for both teams there.
Yeah, both teams picking it up. Getting a little chippy here. Things are getting a little more intense. I think the Axemen don't want to be this close. And don't want to be losing to a lower seed like Memorial, and Memorial doing all that they can here to knock off the higher-ranked Axemen.
Acadia ties it up on the first one. Second shot's good. States is going to re-enter the game now.
Returning to the game, number 8, Brad States.
So Acadia up one now, 4 minutes, 44 seconds remaining in the quarter. Acadia back in this press. Alderman gets his block to play
by Tull.
Tull now one on two, a little too fancy with the dribbling there.
Yeah, no need to go behind your back there. And but turn back over here by
Tull going up for the layup. Great end-to-end action right now. Sloppy play on both sides, but Katie getting the two, now up by three.
Yeah, Tull no reason to go behind your back, but gets bailed out by Sears, who gets a steal on one end and finds him on the other for an easy douche.
Nice job by States there, not backing down. Rejecting in there, but they're going to call him on the foul, going to the line. That would have been States.
Great whistle there by the ref. Not quite sure why. States kind of just holding his ground and then getting the block, but
that would have been
kind of pulled, got lucky there, bailed out by the ref, and will shoot two free throws.
That would have been States' third block of the game. He's doing a great job defensively, filling in for Owen Cross, and he's being rested for the playoffs.
Returning to the game for the Seahawks, number 11, Timo
Sargent. First shot misses. These are the shots that Memorial has to hit if they want to whittle down this lead. Katie up by three now, 51-48. Both shots missed, but gets his own rebound, goes up. That one doesn't fall. States gets the rebound. Fast break opportunity now. Settles it down. Tyler Scott entering the game. And there's Sears going in for the dunk, and it counts, and one. Great play by Anthony Sears.
Yeah, nice drive there by Sears. He blows by his defender, goes for the jam, and gets the foul.
Anthony Sears, the Riverview Nova Scotia product. He's undoing all the tenacity that Katie has seen with the Riverview products who came through the program, basketball and football.
Yeah, he certainly developed his game. Went from just a pure scorer to an all-around player, defender, leader for this action squad, and he'll really be counted on as they go through this playoff push.
Sears doesn't agree with the call, but he gets a foul against him.
Simply just a little reach in there, foul. Not the worst. I like the aggressive traps Katie's trying to do, put some pressure on, but unfortunately they're in the bonus, giving the Memorial some easy free throws here.
Housley going to the line now, and Memorial's going to make some subs. Woodland and Shepard re-entering the game. Housley going to the line to shoot two. Tall entering the game now for Sears. And that's Sears' third foul. Katie wants to avoid the foul trouble that's been plaguing them recently. Last night there wasn't so much, but last weekend they had players fouling out in both games. Kayla gets it up down to Tall. Tall, fast move. Goes in. Forced up the floater. Gail mistimes the jump.
Tall looking to take it hard there. Good play. Looked like he's getting fouled a couple times on those drives, but I think because he's being so aggressive, they're not quite calling. Kind of letting it go. Offense kind of creating the foul might be what the refs are thinking, but he retains the ball here with a four-point lead.
Tall in his first year playing for Acadia, second year of eligibility right now. A transfer student, had to sit out last year. Gonna have to build the reputation to start getting those calls, but at least we're seeing how aggressive he is in his first year as an Axeman.
Yeah, it shows the Axeman here with those two players being in their third year that they got some bright futures ahead of themselves.
Scott with it now, first year. That shot doesn't fall. States mistimes the jump. Fast break opportunity as Tino Sargent advances the ball over to Woodland. Woodland open three. Misses that one. Wishes to have that one back. That was an open look for Woodland. Rushed through the bit there. No one was around him.
Yeah, that's for sure. Kind of shot it up pretty quickly, realizing he was wide open. But unfortunate for Memorial, who trying to keep this game tight here in the last few minutes of the third quarter.
Nash, nice drive in there. Doesn't get it to go. Falls down. You're going to have to get back on defense now. Wood finds Shepard driving in there. Blocking foul call there, and the crowd doesn't agree with that. They wanted the charge on Shepard, but the fifth year draws the foul.
I'm not quite sure if I agree with that one, but that's why we're not at the refs, and I can't quite see what they're calling up here. But probably must have his feet moving and call for the block, and Memorial will shoot two free throws in the bonus here.
Axemen substitution entering the game for Acadia number 22, Shaquille Smith.
Shaquille Smith getting his first appearance in the game today. Got a lot of minutes last night in the winning moments. The first year out of Auburn High School.
Yeah, showing flashes of brilliance. Just for him, it's been a bit of consistency problems. Good shooter, obviously a high flyer, but he's got to be consistent and be a little bit stronger on the basketball. Let's see if he can put in some big minutes here, as we've seen him do in the last few weeks here in War Memorial.
Last weekend, he had one of the most impressive plays of the game, a key block at the end of it, blocking fifth year Manu Gual.
Yeah, that was a big play for the Axemen, who ended up coming back and winning that game. Big credit to him, who, with a lot of foul trouble, came in and did a great job. Let's see if he can do the same here tonight.
Smith with the ball now, trying to find someone. Ferrigiano setting up the offense, down to Smith. Ash, Scott driving in there. Draws the contact, shot doesn't fall, battling down there. States unable to get the rebound as players' bodies go to the floor. Jump ball called, Acadia ball, fresh clock remaining.
Not bad drive there by Scott. Tough bake though, having to go over, leap over a defender. He's got some good hops, but fortunately for Acadia, they retain the ball there on the jump ball.
Coach Benoit from Memorial gets a warning from the referee. Ash with it, slowing down for Jano. Scott cross court, travel called against Shaquille Smith. Katie turns the ball over, 2 minutes, 21 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Katie only up two against Memorial. Memorial putting on a great game right now as they finish the season. This is their last game. Katie next week going to be traveling to Halifax in the Metro Center looking to win the AUS title, playing in the AUS playoffs. Ferrigiano gets the rebound there, gives it up to Ash. Down to the wing, Shaquille Smith. Good ball moving for the Axemen. Finds Scott. Scott driving in there. There's the look he wanted. Great defense there by Wood, as you see him chipping in on a couple of blocks.
Looked like he had an easy layup there, but Wood comes through with the nice little block.
Nice pass to Shepard. Shepard for three. In and out, doesn't go. States gets it. Fast break for Acadia. States going in, one on two. Puts the ball up, gets it to go, and one. Great play by Brad States.
Yeah, tough shot there by States, who was able to get the acrobatic shot to fall for him. Go to the line for the three-point play. The Axemen with a four-point lead here with a minute 39 left in the third quarter.
Getting a substitution now. Theodore Stanov entering the game.
Theodore Stanoyev.
Stanoyev Pardon me, entering the game now. Second year out of St. John's, Newfoundland. State sinks that one. Acadia extending their lead to 5 now. Starting to pull away, but Moore's going to have to answer. Shepherd gets it over to Helsby. Helsby having a great game, leading right now for Memorial. 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Gets it in there. Stanoyev elects to drive.
Defense there by Shaquille Smith.
Shaquille Smith showing his strength on the defensive end. Mishandles it there one-on-one.
Then showing his youth there. Sloppy ball handling leading to the turnover.
Sloppy all over. People are slipping in that area right now. States with it one-on-one. Little one-on-one basketball. Doesn't get it to go, though.
Yeah, not really what you want to see there. Top shot there by States.
Passes out there. Timo Sargent. Helsby finds the hometown product hitting his the shot. Jason Shepherd out of Blackrock, Nova Scotia. Scott hits the 3 with Shepherd in his face.
Andre in his face there. Looks like they got a little trash talking going on the floor here.
Going out of tough right there. Referees might be trying to get them separated. Scott going out with the first year. Scott going at the fifth year. Nice little gamesmanship inside the post, just if you're watching at home. Oh, and States with a hard foul there. Sometimes you see him get up in the air too fast and taking those undisciplined fouls.
Axemen shooting foul committed by number 8, Brad States.
Stanoyev now going to go to the line. That's State's 3rd foul. Katie needs to stay out of foul trouble in the line. Moments there, underhand right now in the post position as Owen Clausen's being rested up for the playoffs. That's a shot again that Memorial's going to have to hit. Stanoyev needs to hit that one, the second year player. That one goes in. A little faster pace right now. 12 seconds remaining. Going to go for that final possession. Sergiano to Ash. Ash pushing off, keeps him away. Sinks that one. Ash has a flair for the dramatic there, keeping Stanoyev off of him, fading away, hitting that long two. Big shot for the Axemen, 62-56.
Yeah, 3-point shot, simply throw to his right, little step back jumper, and he's Cash with the little buzzer beater there for the Axemen to drive a 6-point lead heading into the fourth quarter, showing they can hit a little more shots here and kind of battling here with this young Memorial squad who's hung around all night long.
Memorial really going to have to trying to battle back now. Acadia expanding the lead. Acadia hoping to get this even more so they can get some of their reserves in. Last night we got to see Dustin Poirier and Reese Larry coming and play considerable movement. Shaquille Smith, Tyler Scott all coming in. Young players, first years, third years now, who don't normally see too much playing time. They're with crossing out the key to get players, some of their post players into action, especially Larry, who's certainly a blue chip prospect down the road.
Yeah, he's a big kid who can, if he develops his post game, might be a big threat here for the Axemen, who are looking for a little offensive identity here tonight, but have seemed to have some players step up, get some contribution and scoring all over the floor there for the Axemen in the third quarter anyways. So we'll see if they can keep it going here in the fourth quarter, if the Seahawks team can battle back and reclaim the lead and maybe the victory.
Quite the battle right now if you're watching this right now. Both tied and that's the one. A lucky fan.
And he makes a line to win.
A lucky fan from Acadia Minor Basketball Program that takes place in the Kings County area. Acadia Basketball getting a lot of support and supporting a lot of local initiatives, especially grassroots basketball, hockey, football, soccer, and volleyball. Giving back to the community is an initiative Acadia Sports has. We get the stats right now up to 19 turnovers down for Memorial. Acadia limiting to 8, only 3 turnovers that one, 9 turnovers in that half, in the third quarter. Acadia still being out rebounded 32-28, 10 offensive rebounds for Memorial, 8 for Acadia. Shooting percentage for Acadia right now 36% compared to Memorial, who is also shooting 36%. 3-point field goals, 40%. Acadia now at 26%. Acadia shooting 93% at the line, though. Memorial shooting 76%, missing 5 shots, and now down by 6, and that could be the difference in the game right now, as Acadia is not missing for their free throws. That's State's 4th foul. I think they're going to get him out of the game now, giving him an extended break, as they can't afford to lose him. Lachlan Gale now re-entering.
Yeah, unfortunate for States there, picking up his 4th foul, probably going to sit for a good half of this quarter, as the Axemen are a little undersized here, but going to need collective effort on the boards and all together on the offensive end.
Good game so far, Katie up 62-56. Nice play by Shepard, going inside the paint, getting the two, getting back on defense now.
Yeah,
Katie
showing no fear tonight, being very aggressive here.
Scott there.
An unforced turnover there by Scott.
Scott trying to find someone open. Good ball movement for Katie. With only 10 seconds left. Sears going in, turns it over. Alleman, good defense there, standing his ground, forcing the turnover, going in, drawing the contact, getting it to fall. Nice long call by the referees, letting them really go at it right now.
Good take there by Adelman. Not settling for a jumper, taking it away to the basket.
Ash for three. That one doesn't fall.
Long range.
Nice rebound there. Shepard doing all the little things right now for a squad. Adelman with it. Habib took over in the fourth quarter last game. Shot doesn't fall.
That's a little jump hook there by Memorial. Just can't get it to drop. And fortunate for them, they recover the offensive rebound there. And it's off the Axemen for Memorial basketball. Turnover, though.
Good defense there by the Axemen, bringing the ball up 2 right now. 8 minutes remaining in the game. Nice pass inside. Ash trying to find his big man. Sears resets it right now. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Scott with it from long range. Doesn't get the shot to fall.
Got a lot of long range shots coming. It's what we saw in the first quarter. A lot of standing around and deep threes. When they don't drop, it can kill you.
Stokoe and Tull looking at every entry of the game, as well as Wood for Memorial. Alleman with the ball. Working on Filigiano. Find Housby. Long 2. Doesn't get the fall. Rebounded there by Lachlan Gale. Anthony Sears with it now, returning back to action for the Axemen. Going to get a lot of subs at the next stoppage. Scott finding Lachlan. Nice play by it.
Nice move by Anthony. That's a good find by Lachlan, sorry. And had some better offense there by the Acadia Axemen. We got a little ball movement, little cuts, and leads to an easy layup.
Little tug there by Scott. Ray goes unnoticed by the referee, showing a little veteran play by the rookie's prep school transfer. So Stoker and Tull re-enter the game, taking out Filigiano and Tyler Scott. Woodland and Wood coming in now for Housby and Shepard. We're going to try and inbound the ball now. Howland with it. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Nice drive inside. Doesn't get to fall, though. Over. Lachlan Gale. Caleb Gould having a great game so far when they get him inside. Bit of a mismatch. 6 points for him. Doing a good job. Doing all the little things right now.
Yeah, I think they all probably have come off offensive rebounding here as he's attacked the glass hard.
Good movement by Acadia. Ash, nice contested shot. With a hand in his face, puts it up. Nice job by Anthony Sears.
Hand in his face, but great ball movement. Patient offense there by Acadia, who swung the ball around. Couple players passed up harder looks for an easier shot for Ash, but Memorial comes way back down, hits a three. Habib, hanging right with this Acadia squad.
We saw Habib do this last night here in the big three to start. 6 minutes remaining, Acadia only up 2. Going to be a close finish right now as Tull goes for 3 now.
Blocked.
They said that Ash was out of bounds there. He got the ball. Katie up 2 now. 6 minutes, 24 seconds remaining. Alleman going in. Katie setting up now. Sitting back a bit on defense. Alleman with the ball. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. looking to drive in on Stokoe. Stokoe stands his ground though.
Good D there by Stokoe.
Woodland for three. Shots long. Tall gets it. Fast break for Acadia. Tall slows it down now. Memorial's back. Sears open for three. That one doesn't go. Wood gets the rebound.
We might have rushed that a bit. He had a lot of time there. But unfortunately, can't get it to drop.
Wood with it. Lobs up to Woodland. Woodland goes in. Nice find. Habib. Shot short. Nice. Another offensive rebound. Habib inside. Goes up and around. Lachlan Gale. Tie game. 67-67. Just under 5 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the game.
Yeah, nice play by Habib, who settled for a jumper before that. Missed it. And then instead, this time, drives hard and makes the layup.
Tall with it right now. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Tall for three. Contested. Doesn't go.
Another long range three for the Ashman, who are standing still on offense. Got to get some movement here.
67-67. 5 minutes remaining in the game. Acadia in a tight game right now. Staying around 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. Finding Habib. Habib fade away two. Doesn't go. Stoker on the rebound. Moves it up now. Waiting for you to set up the offense. The young point guard, dual sport athlete out of Ottawa, Ontario. Puts it over to Ash. Stoker open three. Sinks that one. Stoker is with the big three. Acadia up 70-67. 4 minutes, 27 seconds remaining in the game. Alleyman advances the ball now.
Yeah, you can't leave him open if you're Memorial. He will hit that wide open shot all day long, as he did last night and killed the Seahawks.
Woodland with the ball now. Gets inside the paint, goes in one on four, draws a foul, going to get to the line now. Nice play by Woodland. Katie Rimmel, presence in the paint right now without Owen Clausen.
Yeah, they're having trouble stopping the dribble drive right now, and it's causing a lot of fouls. And good play by Woodland there, not settling for the jumper and taking it in and causing a foul.
First shot goes down. Second shot as well. Acadia up 70-69. 4 minutes, 10 seconds remaining. Acadia only up one right now. Three-pointer for Stokoe. Shot doesn't go. Rush that one.
Tipped out by Lachlan Gale. Good crashing the boards there by the action.
Sears looking to pass, gets it to Ash. Good ball movement. Tull crossover inside, nice play. Draws the foul,
nice
gonna get to the line
out there by Tull. Looks like he was driving baseline and slipped it under his legs there, and all of a sudden came out in front of the basket and drew the foul.
Shepard entering the game now for Allenman. Okay, looking to extend their lead now to three, only up 70-69 now against Memorial. Final game of the year, hard fought right now. Going down swinging for sure.
That's for sure. They want to end their year with a W, and they've done all they can so far. See if the Axemen or the Seahawks are going to come out with the victory.
Both shots are good for the Axemen. Yeah, really needing to focus on their free throw shooting, and that's what they've been doing the last two games. Great job by the Axemen for setting up for the playoffs. Beating the press now. Memorial trying to get 7 offense out. Woodland driving. Pass up to Habib. Habib fadeaway two. Tough shot there. Not the one that he wanted to take. Sears with it now. Caleb Gould down. Might be a blood timeout. Guy took a bit of a shot in the mouth there.
Yeah, maybe poked in the eye. We're not sure what exactly happened there as they all went up for the ball.
Got a bit of blood right there. Trainer's going to look at him. Tough play inside the paint there, both teams. It's a tough loss for Memorial right now. Gould's been a bit of a force for the Seahawks offense, especially crashing and getting boards. Gould right now, 6 total rebounds, 4 on the offensive side, especially.
Memorial substitution returning to the game, number 22.
Allerman entering the game now as Gould being 10-2, trying to get the stop the bleeding on the bench right now. Acadia up by 3 now, 3 minutes, 29 seconds remaining in the game. Acadia looking to close out a very productive season, their best one since they went to the national finals. Tall sets up, 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Good use of Acadia trying to bleed all the seconds out as Stoker Lex gets blocked over by Housley.
Yeah, nice try. Nice idea there by Stoker. Just didn't fool anybody. They knew he wasn't pulling up and tried to dish it off, but simply stole by the veteran Helsby.
Nice play. Helsby open for three. Shot doesn't fall. Nice rebound there by Shepard, though, playing in his final game of Memorial. Great interception, though, by Steers. Up to Tull. Tull goes in. No foul called there, but nice little two-handed slam there for Tull, getting back now on defense. Shepard. Pass over, good ball movement from Memorial, gets it into Habib. Acadia collapsing down low though. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Acadia up 74-69. Another interception there. Stoker is known for his interceptions playing football for the football Axemen. Gets it over to Sears. Sears gonna slow it down now. 17 seconds left on the shot clock. 2 minutes, 13 seconds left in the game. Nice drive by Tull, gets it over to Sears. Trying to get it inside now. Long three, doesn't get it to fall. Allerman with it. Habib now going up. Acadia up 74-69, under 2 left. They're going to have to get some points on these possessions now.
Yeah, every possession counts now, so they can't afford any more turnovers.
Housley, nice shot, but unable to get it to fall. Nice offensive rebound. Acadia struggling on the offensive boards right now. Ball tipped inside there, looks to be by Sears. Memorial's center right there, Caleb Gould, really struggling right now. Looks like he's in a lot of pain on the bench there, trying to get the blood to stop. Wondering if they're going to have to stitch him up on the side right now. Tough play there in the paint. Both Acadia and Memorial are crashing the boards. Last night's game was a totally different ball game as Acadia just roared to an early lead. Was up, had 15 points in the first 5 minutes of the game, and now Acadia right now hanging to a 5-point lead.
As well, the 2012 Subway AUS Men's Basketball Championship and CIS Final 8 Men's Basketball Championship presented by Subway. Return to the floor of the Halifax Metro Center with ticket packages for both events.
So as we wait to see what Moore's going to come out with, Coach Benoit right now drawing up some plays, as well as Coach Bauer trying to get his troops ready. Acadia would probably like to get some more reserves in, but with this close game, they got to close it out. Want to go into the playoffs on a winning note right now. Acadia currently on a 4-game winning streak, trying to extend it to 5 now.
Axemen and Axewomen will play next Saturday night in the AUS semifinals.
As the announcer just said, both the Acadia teams have buys into the semifinals. Good chance to get a sweep of AUS titles for the Acadia basketball program.
And I'm sure they could use all the support they could get out in Halifax. So if anybody wants to go out, those games will be held on the...
forcing the three there.
Held on the weekend of March 2nd.
And fouls called. Acadia really forcing these three-pointers right now, struggling with that. Acadia up, 74-69, minute 30 remaining. Tall with the ball.
Double team coming.
Finds Ash open, down to Sears. Sears elects not to shoot, goes in. Nice play by Sears, finishing the game strong there with a nice layup.
Good hang time there by Sears, able to get the acrobatic layup to fall.
Woodland with it now. Gets it into Shepard. Acadia starting to pull away a bit in the waning moments. Housby in trouble now. Finds a bead there, back door. Doesn't get it to fall.
A wide open layup. That could be deadly for this Seahawks squad.
Stoking on a bit of trouble. Ash slowing it down now, 52 seconds remaining. Acadia up 76-69. If they could score on this one, that probably is the game for the Axemen. Oh, hard foul there.
Katie going to the line for two, shooting 93% from the line right now. Something that you want to see from the team as they enter into the go into the playoffs, shooting well when they get the easy points.
Yeah, for sure. It can really save your squad, and a lot of those games come right down to the wire and come down to the free throw shooting, and shooting anywhere in the 90s is definitely terrific. Anywhere in the 80s is really what you're aiming for, but Axemen getting doing a great job here tonight, free throw shooting, that's for sure.
Katie extending the lead now to 9 points. Seahawks taking a timeout, trying to get the trying to get this game back under control. Katie starting to pull away. 78-69, 44.3 seconds remaining in the game.
Yeah, with 44 seconds left, Seahawks are going to need some either quick twos or long, or threes here, and then probably have to do either a quick steal or a quick foul here. Kind of extend this game as long as they can.
So in blue, both coaches drying up some plays, trying to see what's going on. KDO, pretty much their starting lineup back in. We got Brad States early back into the game as he was in travel foul trouble earlier in the game. Joaquin Gale filling in admirably, though, doing a great job defending, trying to get back into the offensive boards for KDO, who would have been struggling to, obviously, without their star player, Owen Fossen.
Yeah, admirable job here by the forwards for the Axemen, who battled hard all game long. And same goes to the Seahawks, who really put up a hell of a fight, had a lead going in after the first half, and quite couldn't pull it out here unless they can pull off a miracle here with 44 seconds left. And Acadia, a 9-point lead.
They're looking to close this one out. 78-69, 44.3 seconds remaining. Seahawks are going to inbound the ball now in the Acadia end. Shepard inbounded. States defending the inbound. Shepard, the hometown player, has quite a few, quite a big contingent from the Memorial fans in Wolfo tonight. Shepard with it, driving in hard, finds the open player, Allen for two, gets Allen to go. Katie up 78-71.
Quick basket is what they needed.
Nice play by Tall, climbing the ladder to collect that high pass. Foul called there.
And the problem trying to trap Acadia and cause turnovers, they are an athletic team playing pretty much with four guards, almost five guards on the floor, with both the forwards being pretty athletic and ball handlers as well. So it's a tough team to cause turnovers, but Seahawks trying to press.
Fourteen seconds left on the shot clock. Acadia up 78-71. 28.8 left in the game. Looking like Katie's going to close this one out. Tough fought game by Memorial, though, who went out on the season swinging. States gets his pocket picked up. A foul called on Helsby. Now to put Katie into the bonus. Katie been shooting well. Free throw line, as mentioned earlier. So States going to the line. Shoot two now and probably close the game out right here.
Yeah, as long as Acadia kind of hits these free throws, I don't see how the Seahawks can really come back with only 27 seconds left here.
First shot's good for States. Second one's good as well. Acadia's only missed one so far. And there's another timeout for the Seahawks. As
this has pretty much been a wonderful weekend here for Acadia Athletics, and definitely Acadia basketball closing out, looking like they're going to get the fourth win here and sweep of the weekend, final home weekend here for Acadia basketball, and from what has been a tremendous year for Acadia Athletics overall.
Hopefully Acadia can go continue this success going in. Acadia, the men's team, looking to go on a five-game winning streak into the AUS tournament, taking place at the Metro Center, taking on whatever it is the higher seed of the two who win. Always a chance of an upset in the AUS tournament, as we saw last year. Acadia upsetting the number two seed Capers as they went on into the AUS final, losing to Dalhousie, but then making it to the making it at the at-large bid into the national championship. The women's team looking to go to their first national championship in recent history. having to buy into the playoffs. So, of course, there's going to be some upsets, and potentially playing Memorial again, potentially playing St. Mary's, which has been a great rivalry this year, watching Justine Coley go against Christy Moore and Emma Dunker. Acadia's been both programs right now have to be very proud, but the seasons, they don't want to waste the successful seasons in by not winning the championships. They both know they have work to do, as you heard Bev Greenlaw say if you were watching the last game, and his little conference at the end saying that the playoffs are a whole different ballgame and anything can happen.
Yeah, that's for sure. Tremendous season, but it's not over here yet for either Acadia squad, and see if they can kind of keep it going in the playoffs and maybe clock some more AUS championships for this Acadia University.
So Sears going to go to the line now as Katie's in the bonus. 19.7 seconds left. Acadia up 80-71. Sears hits these two. Game's almost over. Great effort by Memorial tonight, showing up. They could have just rolled over, as last night they had some issues hitting shots. This one, the game was close all the way to the end. Acadia now just starting to pull away, looking to expand their lead to 10, up 9 points right now, 80-71. 19.7 left in the game.
Yeah, and congratulations to the seniors, Theodore Stanoff and Jason Shepard, on great careers and great competitive game, definitely in the last. Definitely Shepard, hometown kid here, playing a great game in front of his family and friends. So shout out to them and their families. And just unfortunately for the Seahawks, just quite couldn't hang with this highly ranked Acadia squad. And looks like the game's coming to the end here as Axemen shoot a couple more free throws, and the game will be pretty much shriveled out after that.
It'll be interesting to see how Acadia is ranked going into the playoffs, if they manage to crack the national rankings. Only one AUS team currently ranked right now, with St. Francis Xavier. So in 82-73 as the first shot goes. Acadia's lead now up to 10 with 12 seconds left. Starting to pull away now in the waning moments of the game. Acadia had a hard-fought game. There's a foul there called against Tull.
Unnecessary foul. Not sure why they did that, but playing right to the end, I guess, is Coach Bauer's mentality, and something to remember here for later in the year. Let's see if this game will just be dribbled out or no.
Seems like they want them to get into the bonus.
Not sure why they just don't dribble it out, but here we go. Last 8 seconds of the game. More shot by Memorial. Good make.
2 seconds remaining. Probably going to see a foul right here. No, they're going to let the clock go out. Acadia wins 83-75. And with that, this is our final broadcast for Acadia Sports on the SSN Networks. On behalf of Chris Call, myself, Kevin Garbu, I'd like to thank you all for tuning in and watching the games, especially all the sports that we've done this year, hockey, football, basketball, volleyball, women's, and all the other sports, swimming as well. I'd like to thank you all for tuning in and letting us come in, and I'd like to personally thank Athletic Director Kevin Dickey, Communications Director Eric Sederberg, his assistant Richard Johnson, for giving us the opportunity to call these games this year. I've had as much fun. Hopefully you guys all enjoyed it as well, and hope to see you next year if they bring us back. Thank you.